Hello students, welcome back to Relief Tutorials. In the last lecture we have discussed about plastics, different types of plastics, thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Thermoplastics is the plastics which can be remolded on heating, and thermosetting plastics are a tougher one which cannot be remolded. Some common characteristics of plastics. Now the topic is about plastic and environment. See, nowadays wherever you go in your surrounding, if you go to the shop to buy something, so the shopkeeper will give you that things in the plastic bag, polythene plastic bag. The plastic school bags you are using, plastic bottles we use to fill water, soft drinks are also available in plastic bottle in the market. We know the disposable dishes and disposable cups we use in our daily life. So a lot of plastic we are using. At the end of the use of plastic, it is nothing but the garbage for us. Once the plastic is used, it is gradually collected into the garbage. Now how to dispose them? It's a very difficult task because plastic is non-biodegradable substance. So what do you mean by biodegradable substance and non-biodegradable? Biodegradable means the substance which decompose. Decompose means the complex molecules present in the substance are converted into very simpler form, which is harmless for the other living beings, which is harmless for the environment also. So the substances which decompose by bacterial or fungal activity or any other environmental effect. Just like if you consider the piece of bread or any other organic matter, when left undisturbed, or you can say when it is thrown in the open atmosphere or open surrounding, gradually bacteria and fungi decompose it and convert that complex substance into simpler form. And oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, such type of simple harmless gases released from that substance. So gradually that substance is decomposed. So complex substances are converted into simpler form due to bacterial or fungal activity or any other environmental effect like temperature, like moisture, such. So this type of substances which decomposes due to bacterial or fungal activity, those substances are called as biodegradable substance. And non-biodegradable substance means there will be no effect. The substance on which there is no effect of bacteria fungi or any other environmental factor, it remains as it is for a longer time. Such type of substances are non-biodegradable substance. So plastic is non-biodegradable substance. Plastic is non-biodegradable substance which cannot be easily break down into simpler harmless molecules due to action of bacteria or fungi. So such type of substance is non-biodegradable, and plastic is one of them. So such plastic is remain as it is in the environment for the longer time. For example, you have a plastic wrapper or plastic bottle you have thrown anywhere on the roadside or in the forest. So that remains as it is for the longer time. If you throw it in water, it remains as it is in the water. If you throw it on the soil, it remains as it is on the soil for the longer and longer time. So it creates the pollution in air or in soil. Okay, so there are two types of substances, biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Plastic is non-biodegradable substance. Okay, some plastics are recyclable. Some plastics can be remolded, thermoplastics, you know that. So these thermoplastics are recyclable, so that can be remolded and again converted into some other lower grade plastic. So this way some plastics are reusable, so that creates less pollution, but some thermosetting type of plastics which creates greater pollution. Nowadays scientists are working on bioplastic. Bioplastics. This type of plastic is degradable. Biodegradable substance, which is made from the organic matter, which is made from corn starch. Which may be sometimes made from vegetable oil. This type of plastic material, this type of bioplastics are used to form disposable items. So once we use it, we throw it. So wherever you throw such type of bioplastic, because they are a biodegradable substance, they can be again converted into simpler form, so it creates no pollution. So such type of invention or such type of production of plastic is encouraged by the scientists. But still this is undergoing project. Some plastics are available now in the market, but still we have a lot of issue with the plastic. So let us see the topic. Plastic health and environmental hazards. First one, it creates, see what is the harmful effect of plastic on our health or on the environment. Let us see one by one. First one, plastic waste when burnt. Plastic waste when burnt, it creates or it releases harmful gases. So when you burn plastic, it creates toxic or the harmful gases, which leads to air pollution. So it is never advisable to burn plastic to get rid of that plastic. Second, when plastic is dumped or thrown into water, it remains as it is and it creates water pollution. If you dump plastic in soil, okay. So such type of plastic which is buried in the soil, for example, you are burying the plastic waste into the soil. So bacteria or fungi cannot decompose such type of plastic. So gradually For example, this is soil. You can consider one of the plastic wrapper is here, or some plastic bottle you can consider here like this, for whatever the way. Then what happens that it prevent rainwater from seeping to the earth. Rainwater, so the water gradually should be fall, goes down in the earth, but due to this plastic it creates one of the layer. So gradually what happens, the water stopped or prevented to seep into the earth. So it remains, the water is collected here only on the upper part, and it creates the mud. And the underground water, which is our great resource, is gradually decreases. The plastic wrapper which is present in the soil can remain for the number of years as it is, because it is non-biodegradable. So it creates the soil pollution, as well as it stops water to drench into the earth. So air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution. If we throw plastic into the drainage, into the drainage system, so it closes the, for example, this is the pipeline under earth or under the soil, and if you throw plastics continuously in the drainage, then gradually plastic is collected. So it chocks here, this plastic is responsible for closing of drains and sewer lines. So overflowing of drainage, overflowing of sewer lines is just because of what, the collection of plastic waste in the pipeline. So it chocked the pipeline, and such this way the drainage system is chocked. Okay, so if you throw the plastic wrappers of chips, biscuits, etc., or water bottles on the roadside, if you throw these water bottles in the parks, gardens, so it makes the environment ugly. Also, it provides the favorable conditions for germs, insects. These germs or the insects are responsible for disease spreading. If you throw such type of plastic on the roadside, parks, gardens, and if some animal eat it, okay, so sometimes the animal eat plastic. Many times it is heard that some cow or dog, such type of pet animals, may eat such type of plastic, and this plastic remains as it is in their body. It may chock their respiratory system, or sometimes digestive system, and leads to death of animals. Colored plastic, We have seen the different colors of polythene bags, white, black, blue, pink, orange. So this type of colored plastic has chemicals. So the workers which are working in this type of factories, this type of chemicals goes into the respiratory system or sometimes the digestive system, and it can cause cancer to them. So it's very harmful effect of this type of plastic. Okay, during the recycling, you know that thermoplastics are recyclable, reusable. So when you melt thermoplastics to convert it into another item, some chemicals are used, some coloring agents are used. Coloring agents are used during recycling of thermoplastics. Now these coloring agents are very harmful and unhygienic. To keep foodstuffs. So never use such type of lower grade plastics to keep foodstuffs in them. Do not store food particles in such type of colorful, low grade, cheap plastics, because those plastics are recycled from thermoplastics, and some coloring agents, some chemicals are used, and it's totally unhygienic for us. So these are some environmental or health hazards caused due to plastics. Next and the last topic, we have some ideas to solve this problem, solution to problems caused by plastic. We have 5 R principle. 5 R: refuse, reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. Refuse, reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. First of all, refuse. Don't ask for plastic bags from the shop or the malls. Use your own clothing bag, jute bag, or any other cloth bag, cotton bag. So use that type of bag when you go for shopping. So first of all, refuse to use plastic as much as possible. Do not ask for plastic bags when we go for shopping. Instead of that, we should carry your cotton or jute bag. So this is refuse. We are refusing to use as much as possible. Okay. Reduce the use of plastic. Reuse. For example, you have a water bottle you have purchased, or some cold drink bottle you have purchased from market. Then once you use that bottle, clean it very well and reuse to store something. Plastic containers, dry plastic bags should be used for another purpose, just like we use that bottles for carry water from one place to another. So that is what the thing, but the reuse concept. So as much as possible, reuse plastic bottles. I'm not saying that all types of plastics are reusable, but as much as possible, you reuse it. Nowadays, there is a concept of two dustbins at our homes or in the industrial. Green bin, green dustbin, and blue dustbin. So, in the green dustbin, degradable substance should be thrown. Biodegradable substances, such type of waste should be collected in the green bin. Just like the fruits, peels of fruits, vegetables, leftover food, cotton, paper, breads, such type of organic matter should be thrown into green bin. And non-biodegradable substances are collected into blue bin, like plastics, fibers, such type of waste should be collected into blue bin. So this way, the garbage collectors has a direct option to collect plastic, and they can melt it and recycle it. Fourth one, we should not throw. We should not throw plastic items on roadsides, gardens, forests, because it harms the atmosphere, harms the environment, and also if some animal eat this type of plastic, it can cause death of them. Never dispose plastic items in sewage system, drainage system. Don't throw them in such type in the sewage system or in the drainage system, because it can choke the pipelines and creates problem for us. Okay, so these are the five solutions to get rid of the problems created by plastics. Okay, so this is the end of the chapter, end of the concepts. We should develop environment friendly habits to get rid of the harmful effects of plastics. So students, keep practicing. You have exercise on page number 52-53. So please refer them. And if you have any doubt, you can call at any time. So what's your homework? Complete exercise. Okay, best of luck.